Assalamu alaikum students, today we're going to discuss our last topic of chapter number 1, computer software. And I'm Maria Naseem from Meme Grammar School. What is a software? As name indicates, it is something basically soft. Computer instructions or data, anything that can be stored electronically is known as software. The example of softwares are MS Word, Excel, PowerPoint, spreadsheets, library management system, etc. And you can see there are some software also given: Adobe, Google Chrome, Recycle Bin, Explorer, Office, Outlook Express. So these are different software categories. Then there are some types of software. One is system software, another is application software. Basically, your software is divided into two main categories. And you can see in the diagram also, the most inner portion is the hardware. Hardware is concerned with the system software. System software is directly concerned with the hardware. And then application software connect with the hardware using a system software. So basically, system software works as a bridge between hardware and application software. So let's just discuss about these two types. System software. The system software consists of operating system and all the utilities that enable the computer to function. System software actually control the hardware so that application software can perform any action or task. Basically, whatever tasks are performed by the computer is due to system software. If there is no system software, there will be no functionality performed by computer. Example of system software are operating system, compiler, loader, linker, interpreter, and etc. Or operating system, if you talk about the operating system, that means basically a Windows or any operating system that basically running your computer. Then we have types of system software. There are operating system, utilities, device drivers, and language translators. Let's just discuss one by one. Okay, then first of all, let's just discuss about application software. Application software includes programs that do real work of user. For example, payroll systems, inventory control, manage student database, word processors, spreadsheets, and database management system. And there are so many others also. Then there are application software, categories of application software, types of applications, forms of application software. Different categories bhi hai, then there are different types of application software, and there are different forms of application software also. Categories of application software. Business software, as it named indicates, used for business purpose. Graphics and multimedia, it's used for this type of functionalities, which includes graphics and some multimedia. Home, personal, education, then communication. These are different categories of application software. Types of application software are proprietary, in-house, contract, off-the-shelf, or customized package. We will discuss these in detail also. Then there are forms of application software: package software, custom software, web applications, open source, shareware, freeware, and public domain software. These are basically the highlighted areas what we're gonna discuss. What is application software? Actually, the application software consists of programs that are designed to make users more comfortable or productive to assist personal tasks. As names indicate, basically it is application software. These are designed to perform certain tasks. The application software is present on the computer hard disk. Application software can also be stored on CDs, DVDs, and flash or keychain storage devices. Types of application software. Proprietary. Proprietary software is a licensed software under exclusive legal right of owner. As its name indicates, proprietary. That means there are some in-house. In in-house software, we develop application with the help of a company resources. Off-the-shelf, an existing software program that can be used without any changes expected. For example, if you do not change any, make any changes in the software, you can use it off-the-shelf. Contract. The software which is developed for a specific company for their requirement is known as contract application software. Form of application software, package software. The most common example of package software is Microsoft Office, which includes Microsoft Office Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Access, and Outlook also. A software which is sold in a bundle due to a similar functions of programs. Example are Microsoft Office, Windows CD. Then we have custom software. This is a software which is specially made for an organization as per their requirement. For example, sometimes a company need a software for their some particular task or some certain issues. So they ask a developer to make a custom software for their requirement. Example are attendance system for school or maybe for office, security code system for some company. Web applications. A web application is any application that uses a web browser. Examples are Google Documents, Dropbox. All of you are familiar with the Dropbox, and you can take an example of a Google Drive also. So these are example of web application. Then there is another category, open source software. Open source software is made available to everyone and can be changed, modified, and distributed to public without any notification. As its names indicate, it is open source. So once you have downloaded it, it is free of cost, open source. As its names indicate, open source is free of cost. So you can download it, you can make changes in that, and you can maintain your changes and without any notification. You do not need to tell the owner about that. Then we have freeware. Freeware is the software that is freely available to the public, but author has a copyright, means that you can only use it, not sell it. The difference between open source software and freeware is that you can download these both, but you can make changes in the open source software. You cannot make changes in the freeware. You can only use it. The example of this type of software is antiviruses. Then shareware. Shareware is actually delivered free of charge, but sometimes the owner asks for money to get registered so that they can send updates in future. It can be copied but cannot be sold. The example of this type of software is the Internet Download Manager also. As you have seen, after 30 days it gives you a pop-up that please register it for further usage. And there is an example, Geno numbers in Microsoft Office also. Of course, it also asks you for product key after 1 month or after some certain time period. Public domain software is totally free and it is not copyrighted, plus it have no restrictions. Examples are SQLite, Blast, 12p, and you can search other also. System software. In system software, programs are designed to operate, control, and enhances the processing capabilities of the computer. As I have told you before, basically without system software, a computer cannot work. System software is developed by a computer manufacturer in low-level languages. It also helps hardware components to work together and provides support for the development and execution of the application software. Programs which are included in system software package are known as system programs, and the programmers who develop those programs are known as system programmers. And you can search about it more. Types of system software. Operating system. An operating system is a software which manages computer hardware and software resources. It also provides common services to computer programs. As I have told you before, system software works between hardware and application software. And then there is the operating software, operating system, which is a type of system software, and basically it helps the computer to perform all its tasks from hardware and software resources. The operating system is an essential component of the system software in a computer system. That means without operating system, a computer cannot run. Application programs are dependent on operating system to function. Utilities. Utilities software is a system software which is manufactured to help analyze, configure, optimize, or to maintain a computer. It also helps in maintenance and problem solving of a computer. Common types of utility programs are hardware utilities, virus detection and recovery utilities, file compression utilities, spam and pop-up blocker utilities, backup and uninstall. Device drivers. device driver is actually a communication device between device and computer. It loads every time in memory. When a new device is added, the driver should be installed in order to run the program. For example, you have attached a USB. Most of the time you have seen on the right bottom corner of your monitor screen that it is written over there that a new file is installing or device driver is not installed or is installing, TK is installed. These type of statements are written over there when a new device is attached. Okay, when the next time you attach that device, it doesn't show you the same statement, because once it is attached, the driver is installed, the next time you will attach that USB device, it does not ask you for the driver again. Then features of system software, these are close to system, that means close to hardware, fast in speed, difficult to design because we are dealing with the machine language in that, difficult to understand for human beings but easy for machines, less interactive because basically the graphics portion of the computer software, Windows, is a part of an application software, that's why this is not interactive area, smaller in size, difficult to manipulate, generally written in low level languages. The one more category which is not discussed over here is a language processor. Basically, language processor is a type of a system software and it helps the system to communicate between application software and a hardware. Sometimes it has happened that a program or a software is written in application software is written in a high level language, and definitely we want to perform some certain task. So there is a language processor which translates from a high level language to low level language. And then the computer hardware can understand that. These type of softwares are known as language processors. And these are a types of system software. Now we will discuss from the book also. And at the end we're going to discuss the exercise. And then our chapter 1 will be complete. Okay students, you can see book page 29, chapter number 1, topic 1.5, computer software. And we have discussed all the details. Let's just go through the from a book also. Computer programs are known as computer software, and basically they tell the computer what to do and how to do in the form of instructions. Then we have different categories: system software and application software. We have discussed about system software, basically are collection programs which make the use of computer easy and efficient. Then, as we have discussed before, there are different types of system software: operating system, device drivers, utility programs, and the one I was discussing with you that it was not mentioned in those slides, that was language processor. All the same details are given over here also. Operating system is an essential part of the computer, responsible for the management and coordination of all the activities performed by the computer. It interacts with the computer hardware to operate computer. And these are the basically tasks performed by operating system, and we have discussed about these in the slides. Then we have discussed about the device drivers also. Device drivers basically helps any new hardware component to work with the computer. Device driver is a system software that controls the operation of a computer device. Device drivers are provided by sometime device manufacturers also. Okay, then there are utility programs. Utility programs perform specific tasks that are related to management of the computer, and there are different utility programs we have discussed. And then on the next page, language processors, as we have discussed before, they basically help to translate from a high level language to low level language, because all the programs are written in high level languages nowadays, and computer understand the machine language. There are compiler and interpreter also. These are used to translate from high level to low level languages. And then there is an assembler also, which is specifically for the assembly language, to translate assembly language into machine language. Then we have application software. There are categories of application software. We have discussed productivity software, business software, entertainment software. Entertainment software, software developed to entertain people, is known as entertainment software. These are mostly games and for some fun activities. And you need to see over here, Edutainment. Edutainment means games and education. Those software which are basically a games on the basis of education. Edutainment software is used mainly for entertainment, but it educates as well. Then there are educational software. Education software developed for educational purpose is known as education software. Then there are different types of categories of application software: open source software, shareware, and freeware. As we have discussed in the slides also about open source software are those in which you can make changes also. Okay. And then shareware is available for a limited period of time, then you have to purchase those softwares. Freeware are always free for you. You can download them and use them for a long period of time. Their examples are Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, VLC Media Player, and etc. Let's just discuss the exercise. Okay, students, question number one. These are basically multiple choice question. On the page number 33, you can see I have highlighted the answers for you. You can see one is B, then B. You will read it. These are correct answers. Please note down the answers. And then let's just discuss about the short questions. Okay, students, we have already covered the question number 1, question number 2, and question number 3. Question number 4, 5, 7, and 9. These answers will be in your description of the link. Okay, YouTube link description mein you can get those answers. Then there is a question: differentiate between system software and application software. I'll be giving you the image or a picture for this answer, and you can find out the answer from your book also. Give any three uses of a computer in a school library. You can find out the answer on the internet. This question number 7 is basically your assessment. Uses of computer in a school library. Then name few household appliances in which microprocessor is used. This is also your assessment. You have to find out this answer on your own. Then in the long questions, we have done the question number 1. We have done the question number 2. We have done the question number 4 also. Explain the basic operations of a computer is a question number 3. You can find out the answer on the page number 28 and 29. And then last question is types of application software on the page number 30. Okay, your chapter 1 is complete with that. In our next video, we're going to start the chapter number 2. And the chapter number 2 is fundamentals of operating system. Now you all know basically what is operating system. We're going to discuss in detail about the operating system.